Hi, in this session we'll see how to validate the data. In previous session we have added the data to the WorkQ, right? Now we will see how to validate the data. Here, if you observe which all the records are invalid records where we don't have commission, right? Where we don't have commission, those are invalid records. These three records are invalid records. By using the WorkQ, we need to identify these three records. We are going to separate valid records and invalid records by using WorkQ status. We'll see how to do that. Here, we have added the data up to WorkQ, right? Next, we need to process the data. We need to process the data. To process the data, we are going to use another action in a WorkQ. Get next item. Get next item. Why item ID is coming here? We can understand now. Get next item. See this, what it is asking? WorkQ name, emp underscore WorkQ. This is our WorkQ name. Next, when you are adding, again you have two things, item ID and collection data. Okay, when you trying to create, already we have a collection with the data. Let's give it as a, this is for data underscore row by row basis, right? So R I have given. Okay, now it has created. I will explain why we required these two things. Now get next item, what it will do is, when you coming to the control room, here we have a data, two sets of data we have. I will remove one set of data. It's not required, two sets of data. Let me delete. When you want to delete, observe this, we don't have delete option, right? We cannot able to delete each and every record. We are going to call here as a work case, work cases. If you want to delete, you need to mark it as an exception. Then only we can able to delete. Now all these are marked as exception. Now you can able to delete. Now we have only one set of records, right? What WorkQ will do is, it will process the data first in first out process. Queue process. Which record entered into the WorkQ first? 101. It will process 101 first. When it's completed, then only it will process 102. It has to pick one by one. For that, we are using get next item here. It will pick next item ID from your WorkQ. Only remember, get next item, it will pick only available pending item IDs from your WorkQ. These are item IDs. Only pending item IDs from your, it will not pick completed, it will not pick locked. Remember, only it will process pending. Okay, now coming to this, so we are given, but why we have created outputs for item ID and then again one more collection, right? Here we have already item IDs. This is unique identifier. Why item ID required here is, we are going to, WorkQ is going to process the data based on item ID only. Observe this. If you observe previously, here we have two sets of data, right? If the WorkQ is processing based on primary key, here our primary key is employee ID 101. Again, you saw that 101 in your WorkQ list, right? Why it came here? WorkQ will not process based on this particular employee ID. It will process the data based on, within that, based on item IDs. If the same data, if you want to process again also, it will create new item ID for that. That's why this item IDs is required. WorkU internally, it will generate unique identifier. Based on this unique identifier only, WorkU will process the data. That's why we required another item ID and then that particular record collection, because we need to cross check whether the record is available or not. And for that particular record, we need to check the commission is available or not, right? It has to pick one by one. WorkU, how come it will understand how many records is available? It based on, see this, when item ID is null, right? Consider this is item ID. When it is null means, when employee ID is null means, we don't have any record here, right? For that, we are going to give the collection here by using, we are going to give the condition by using decision. What you can do is, in a decision, if item ID equal to null, you can give null means like this, equal to null. Or you can give length of item ID equal to zero. That is also valid one. Length means the length of this particular one. Length is 3 here. Length is 4 here. Length is 2 here. Length 0 means we don't have anything, right? So here we have given item ID equal to null. If it is null means we don't have any records. Simply end the process. We don't have any records. End the process if it is null. But if you are having record, then what it has to do? It has to check commission is null or not. Here, our business requirement is to cross check whether commission is null or not. Only we are working for one specific column here. Like this, you can work for n number of specific columns also, n number of business rules. Our requirement is to check valid, invalid based on your commission. When your commission is null, then it is an invalid record. To check that, we required the commission data. Again, we required another decision here, right? Let's take another decision. And then for that particular record, we required, right? That's why this collection, it came into the picture. Now, from this collection, dot, what is the name of that column? Commission, right? Commission equal to null. If it is null means, then that is also invalid record, right? If it is null, yes. If it is not null, no. See this? One is yes, one is no. If it is null, yes means, then it is an invalid record, right? This is for invalid record. Invalid record, we have an action called, see this, mark exception. Mark exception, it will mark that particular item ID as an exception, because we are processing based on item IDs. We'll mark it as a invalid commission value, right? We have given the exception reason. That we required here output is nothing, not required. Okay. Now, if it is no, we don't have any records in a commission, then it is valid record, right? For the valid, we have an action called in a work queue, get mark completed. Mark completed for this completed item ID, because we are processing based on item ID only, right? This is only for one record, right? Only for one record, right? Get item ID, it will pick one record. What about the remaining things? For remaining records also, it has to do the same process. So we are going to give it to, again, get next item. Once one first record is completed, it is going to pick the next record, right? Now, already we have a data there in your work queue. Now let's run it from here. Now observe, set next stage. we are going to run get next series. It has picked our record, right? 101 it has picked. Now it is going to check the condition. It is a valid record, right? And then it is going to the next record. When it is going to next record, observe this again. It has picked the next record, right? To get this, we have given this particular collection in your get next item ID. When we are observing here in our control room, let me refresh. See this 101, it's processed, completed. 102 is locked. It means still it is processing, right? Again, come to this OQ. Again, we are going to run this. This is invalid record, right? It will go and then it will pick the another one, which is next readily available, right? See this 102. What is this? Exception. What is the reason of the exception? Invalid commission value, right? Two things is completed. What is the next queue? 103. Like this, your work queue is going to process your data one by one. Let me run this. Observe this. It will process all the data till your decision is here. Item ID equal to null. It means how many records we have there here. Item IDs. All the records it will process. Right? Like that, work queue will understand how many records is available in your work queue. Based on that, it will pick one by one record. Here we have given a business rule for one specific column, right? The same way you can give the business rules for n number of columns based on our requirement. After one decision, you can add multiple decisions and then you can do the same thing. Like this, we are going to decide how many valid records, how many invalid records in our work queue. Let's observe this here. See this, how many records processed? Almost all the records has been processed, right? Once it is completed, if you observe here, end, right? All the records is completed. Like this, we are going to understand how many valid records and how many invalid records available in your work queue. Now, see this, how many invalid records we have? Three remaining, all other than these three, remaining all are valid records, right? Okay, so hope you understand. So thank you. In next session, we'll see how to differentiate valid records and invalid records. Thank you.